All right, it looks like we're done with initial navbar CSS. But before we worry about styling the big screen layout, let's quickly knock out the toggle functionality. And as a side note, if you're not comfortable with JavaScript, you can simply copy and paste the code from the final directory. And the idea is following: on a small screen, we want to hide all the links by default. And we'll do that by setting up the height 0 in nav links. And in order to show them, we'll create a new class with the current height of the nav links. And lastly, in JavaScript, we'll toggle the nav links by adding and removing the show links class. So the end result should look something like this, where if I make my screen size smaller, just notice we have the button. And once we click, we show the links. And once we click one more time, of course, then we hide the links. And like I already mentioned, the plan is following, where we'll find the nav links. There it is. We have our to do. And before we do anything, before we set height 0, I actually want to check the height of the nav links. So let's open up the dev tools. We're looking for the elements. And more specifically, we're looking for the nav links. And I can see that the height for the nav links is 309.79 pixels. And once I know that info, I'll create a class. I'll say show links. And in there, we'll set up the height to be exactly that, whatever we have right now for the nav links. And in my case, I'm going to go with 310 pixels. And once I have this height, now, of course, I want to go to the nav links. And like I said, by default, we'll hide them. So say here, height is equal to 0. Then we also need to set up the overflow hidden. Otherwise, you can clearly see that we can still see the links. So let's go over here, overflow hidden. And we also want to add the transition, because when we'll be toggling, I actually want that toggle effect to happen over time, not instantly. So therefore, we'll go here with transition. And we'll just be looking for the CSS variable, the transition one. And once we have all of this in place, we can actually test it out by just adding and removing the class, the show links one, in the DevTools. And then, of course, we'll navigate to the JavaScript file and add a functionality there as well. So let's go to the big screen. I always find it to be easier working there. So let's inspect. And of course, I'm looking for the nav links element over here. And then just click on the class. And right next to the nav links, just go with show links. And what you'll notice, the moment you press enter, of course, now we can see the links. And if I remove the class, then you can probably already guess that we won't be able to see the links. And effectively, the only thing we need to do right now is just navigate to the JavaScript file. So let's go to the directory, the JavaScript one. We're looking for app.js. And in here, we'll start with simple hello world. And then back in the index.html, we want to set up the script tags. So let's say here script. And as far as the source, again, we're pointing to the JavaScript folder and then the app.js. And if you can see the hello world in a console, then of course, we're moving in the right direction. And as far as the app.js, you can select the nav links and nav button directly. But I always like to set up a function that gets me that element. And if the element doesn't exist, so essentially, if I get back the null, then I just throw the error. Might seem like an overkill on a small project, but I still decided to share the functionality. So in here, we want to go with const get element. And then we'll pass in the selector. So this is going to be either the nav links or nav button or whichever element you want to select. And then first, let's go with const element. So now we'll select it and we'll say document and then query selector. And now we pass in the selector. And you probably already know that in vanilla.js, if there is no element, so if I pass in some kind of selector that doesn't point to an element, of course, I'll get back the null. So I'll say here, if element exists, and only if it exists, then I'll return the element. Otherwise, I'll throw the error. And I'll just say throw and error. And of course, I'll pass in some kind of message. And in this case, I'm going to go with template string. I'll say please double check your class names. And we'll go with there is no. And of course, now I'm looking for that selector. And let's add a class here. And once I have the function, of course, we can test it out, where I'm going to go with const links. So now I'm selecting the nav links, and we'll pass in the class of nav links. And if I don't see anything in the console, then of course we are in good shape. Now, if I'll add some class name that doesn't point to an element, then of course we'll have, please double check your class names. There is no blah, blah, blah class. Hopefully that is clear. So now of course we can set the proper class here, copy and paste. We're going to be looking for nav BTN in this case. And of course we also need to change the name here. So nav BTN and then DOM. And then let's just add a event listener on a button, the click event. And then every time we click the button, we'll toggle the show links class. So we'll add and remove class on the links element. So let's say over here, nav BTN, then add event listener. And then we'll be listening for click events. And of course, we need to pass in the callback function. And as far as the logic, we'll simply go with links, class list, and then toggle. So class list is the property. On there we have toggle method. And in here we just need to say which class we want to toggle. Keep in mind that in here you don't need to pass in the dot. We already know that we're talking about the class, so you simply need to provide the class value. And the moment I save, I can see that I have no bugs in the console, which is always a good sign. And then of course, notice as we're clicking, we're toggling the links. So if you want to test it out on a big screen, of course you can do that. And you'll clearly see that the moment I click, I show links over here. Notice how we're again adding this class. Of course, in this case, we're not doing this manually. And then once we click one more time, then we hide the links. And before I let you go, let me just say that I'm fully aware that we are cheating a little bit. Simply because if we change the amount of links, our functionality is not going to work as expected. Because keep in mind that back in the main CSS, we're actually hard coding this height value. So of course, as we're going to be adding more links or removing the links, our functionality is not going to work as expected. And if you took my JavaScript course, you probably worked on a project where we covered the proper toggle functionality. But since it's not the main focus of the project, I decided to take this route instead.